Good evening. My name is Suzanne Cooley, and I'm the principal of Hunter and Central Regional High School. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the ninth grade orientation program for the class of 2024. It is also my pleasure to officially welcome you into the Hunter and Central family. First thing I would like for you to know is that you are not alone. From this moment on, you are part of an extraordinary team of individuals, some of whom you will hear from this evening, others who you will meet in the days and weeks ahead, all of whom are committed to ensuring that you have a meaningful and valuable experience as members of the class of 2024. The second thing I would like for you to know is that Hunter and Central is a very large high school. Yes, it's true, and as unnerving as that may be to some of you, and right now I'm speaking primarily to the parents, as it always seems to be much more unnerving to the parents than to the students. We've put systems in place to make a large school feel more intimate and a bit smaller. The house system is one way that we do that. The house system is made up of grade level teams and includes those individuals you see listed here. Mr. Schnabley is your vice principal, and he will become one of your biggest advocates. Mrs. Cruz is the ninth grade house office secretary. You will go to her for just about everything. Mrs. Childs, Ms. Coppola, and Mr. Coverley are your grade level counselors. Make a point to get to know them well. Mrs. Heller, the ninth grade SAC, is a specialized counselor and another great support. Mrs. Nectarline, college and career counselor, it's never too early to begin thinking and planning ahead. Mrs. Larson is a ninth grade nurse. She will tend to your health and medical needs for the next 4 years. All of these people will follow you through for your next 4 years. Last but not least is you. Throughout the remainder of the program this evening, you will hear how you, as a member of the class, will contribute to the team. At this time, I would like to introduce the vice principal for the class of 2024, Mr. Richard Schnabley.
Thank you, Ms. Cooley. Greetings. My name is Mr. Schnabley. I will be the vice principal for your sons and daughters over the next 4 years. Tonight, I wish to give you an overview of some of the incidentals to allow for smooth transition to Hunter and Central for both you and your children. There are several sources for information at Hunter and Central. First and foremost is the house office, Mrs. Cruz, our house office secretary, and myself. Second, your classroom teachers and department supervisors are the best sources of information when dealing with curricular matters. And finally, our school website and listservs will provide you with up-to-date information on current and upcoming events. A few housekeeping requirements include, per New Jersey law, the submission of a current physical within the past 365 days, and two forms of proof of residency documentation. Examples of the proofs of residency are included here. Photocopy of the property deed, current property tax bill, current lease utility bills. What to bring? Chromebooks will be distributed at the in-person orientation. Parents, the $30 insurance purchase is good to consider. It covers repairs or replacement of the Chromebook devices for the duration of the freshman year. That then will become renewable each subsequent year that your sons or daughters are in attendance. Day one, get up early, begin to establish a routine. I would advise you to take the bus. If you're planning on being dropped off, you need to know that you're going to be accompanied by about 80 large school buses and 700 cars converging onto the campus between the hours of 7 and 7:30. So therefore, the bus might be the best option. Classes begin promptly at 7:35, and tardy to school and class are recorded. The first day, and only the first day, we will do an alpha homeroom, again, beginning at 7:35. Dismissal will help your sons and daughters find their buses in any of the three zone locations on campus. If you choose to pick your son or daughter up early, please be advised that we need a parent note, preferably 24 hours in advance, submitted to the freshman house office. And that would be on any day of the 180 days that your sons and daughters are in school. Dismissal time every day until further notice is 12 noon. Day two is a B day. Same bell schedule as day one, except we're going to extend our second block class to review our safety and security procedures. Day three, we'll be back to an A day, and again, we'll be running in planned early dismissal, 12 noon dismissal, bell schedule. Our attendance policy may be found on the website along with our student handbook and our code of conduct. This details the number of absences until your sons and daughters run into a loss of credit situation. Our goals for the class of 2024, you're young adults now, no longer middle school students. As such, you'll be given more freedoms, but with those freedoms come responsibility. It's my belief that high school should be the most enjoyable time in your students' lives. Have fun, but be responsible. I wish you well. Ms. Curley will now address our counseling service department.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Dana Curlew, and I'm the Supervisor of Counseling Services. I want to thank you again for joining us tonight virtually. We are excited to have you learn about orientation, as well as to help you learn how to help your children transition successfully to the high school. We know that this is an adjustment for your son and daughter, and we want to take a moment to assure you that we know that this is an adjustment for you as well.
So to start tonight's presentation, I'd like to share with you again the counseling services staff that will be working with your child. You can see here that Linda Childs is the counselor for letters A through F. Jacqueline Coppola is the counselor for letters G through NAV. And Kevin Coverley is the counselor for students NAW through Z. We also have Stacey Heller, who is the ninth grade student assistance counselor. And Jen Nectarline is the college and career counselor. So in the next few days or weeks, you may have questions about schedules, placement, classes, homework, tutorial, or activities. And all of these questions should be directed back to the school counselor to start. Also, if there's anything going on that you think that your counselor may need to know, so for example, if your child's having a bad day or you have a family obstacle that you're facing, it's important to let them know so they can assist you and your child as well and make teachers aware if that's something you feel would be helpful. So here at Central, we're extremely lucky to have another team of counselors for your children available. In addition to the grade level counselors, we have both student assistance counselors and school-based counselors who are from the medical center that are here to meet with students regularly who are dealing with more in-depth issues. Typically, the grade level counselor will refer students after meeting with them if there's a need. In addition, we're also a school that has a college and career counselor. She works diligently with our counselors to make sure they are up to date on college and career trends and changes, and she works with the students in groups as well with the grade level counselors. We have a strong, dedicated team of caring individuals here to help you every step of the way. So if you need to remember who the assigned counselor is, this is a quick visual of where to find us on the website. You can see that you go to the counseling website, and then, or counseling tab, and then on the left is contact information, and it's broken down by grade level. So you see class of 2024, we'll list all of your counselors that are there. We also will share the alphabetical breakdown for you. So this slide briefly goes over the counseling curriculum and the goals for each year. So you can see during freshman year that we're working to get to know your child and transitioning them here to the high school. And we're also developing a successful academic foundation with them. Sophomore year is getting to know them as a person and having them have that knowledge of their self, and then also work with them on career pathways that align with their interests. Junior year, we're preparing for the future, and that's college and career options. And then senior year, we're finalizing future plans with applications to college, to military, to jobs, and then transitioning them. And during this time, we continue to work with them socially, emotionally, and academically to assist them in any way they need. And we know that every child is going to have a unique experience and have unique talents and skills. So our promise to you is that your counselor will work with you and your child to develop a four-year plan that assists them in reaching their goals and aspirations. And it will be a time for them to discover their passion and build their confidence and find that balance between their schedule and academics with activities and to have fun while they're here during their 4 years. So how else can you help your son or daughter enjoy their experience here? It's very important that we all work together to help them find the balance that I mentioned before. We want to make sure that your son and daughter creates that balance in their life with their academics, but also with activities, athletics, community service, and work experience. It's important to encourage them to explore and take different courses such as music, tech design, art, and give them time to try out new clubs or activities. This is how they will build their self-confidence and meet new friends that share interests. So how can you help your son or daughter transition here to the high school? Well, this is a transition in so many ways. It's a new building, it's new curriculum, new friends from sending districts, and really they're changing into an adult. You know, think about it, they're 13 to 14 year old freshman, so technically biological adult, that I think we can all agree are not emotionally ready, socially ready, or economically ready to be on their own. But they do feel independent, and we can help them as parents to navigate the next 4 years. So what can we do? I love this slide because it talks about the difference between managing versus consulting, and how we as parents, we spend years 1 through 12 helping to manage their life. And this switches more into a different form of parenting, which I'll call coaching. So that means really letting them know that we're here for them and listening to them, as opposed to really making all of those decisions for them. So it'll be important for us as parents to validate them, no matter what the scenario is, and empathize with them, but also to listen and stay calm and try not to give them all the answers. We want to guide them to the answers, and I know that's a difficult transition for a lot of us, but you can certainly turn to your counselor if you're having any kind of issues or struggles or need any assistance with this. I love this slide because it reminds us as parents that not everything's going to be easy for our children. And there may be times where they fail or don't do as well on a test or in their athletics competitions, or even scenarios with friends or teachers. So we want to make sure that we remind them that failure is something that gives us more opportunity to think differently and try different angles. It's really a valuable life lesson to teach our children. And how can you support your child from home academically? So here's some tips that we often share as counselors. So we remind parents to have that structured homework time in a location that's conducive to learning, such as an office with limited distractions or a table that's in a quiet environment. We want to help them limit their cell phone usage during this time. We want to encourage regular bedtimes for students and breakfast in the morning that will help them be successful during their day at Central. We also want to help them monitor their progress, but just not daily. Maybe set a once a week reminder to check in to Aspen together or review homework or materials. And remember that you can always call the counselor or teacher for support if you notice there's an issue with any of the classes. So when will your child meet their counselor? They're going to have an opportunity to meet a counselor on staff during orientation over the next 3 days. They'll also have individual meetings and group meetings where they'll get to know their counselor one-on-one. They'll discuss scheduling. They'll work on four-year planning. They'll also, typically, we offer an early college planning, and that's in PE courses, so we'll keep you up to date if that's going to be offered virtually this year. But remember, your son and daughter can email the counselors at any time. They can stop in to make appointments, or they can fill out slips to make appointments and leave them in the counselor's door. And lastly, the freshman team will be sending out an interview sheet that will be sent through the school email to your son and daughters directly. So this form will help the counselors get to know them. And we ask that you remind your son or daughter not to stress over these answers, and that if there's something they don't feel comfortable answering, they certainly do not have to fill out the entire form. And we ask that they print them back or email them back to the counselor directly.
That concludes the counseling portion of tonight's presentation. Have a great night. And have a great year.
Hello, my name is Edward Brandt. I am Dean of Students here at Hunterdon Central, and I want to welcome all the class of 2024 and look forward to working with you not only this year, but in the upcoming 4 years of your high school career. I also want to welcome all the new upperclassmen who are joining us as well. Welcome. This is your school. Put your stamp on it, and I'm going to help you hopefully find ways that you can do that along your journey. One of the areas that I work with is on the areas of wellness and also student athletics and activities. I want to highlight the fact that we have many activities here, over 50 clubs and organizations that you can get involved with, and over 30 varsity level athletics. Our activities and clubs cover a variety of different ways to meet your passions and interests. We have clubs that deal with service, both to school and the community. We have clubs that tap into your personal interests and passions. And we hope that all of these help bring the learning that you have here at school into life way beyond your classes. It's an excellent way to build a sense of community here at Hunterdon Central. I want to talk a little bit about what to expect in the upcoming freshman orientation. This week, we have three orientations broken up by alphabet, in order to help maintain careful and safe sizes of students. Students drop off are going to be up at the 910 receptionist area, also known as the fountain lot. It's the main lot right off of Route 31. All of the students are going to be dropped off there. They're going to join their group of 20 students, along with a staff member and another student, who are going to walk them through a tour of campus. Along that tour, they're going to have a few stops along the way. One of those stops is going to be meeting their house office group, which includes Mr. Schneebly, the vice principal, Ms. Cruz, the house secretary, and other members of our staff that are going to help paint the road for you over the next 4 years. Another stop is going to be meeting Mr. Spencer and myself out on the football field or in a cafeteria, depending on weather, to talk a little bit about student activities and athletics and life here at Hunterdon Central. A third stop along the way is going to be meeting support staff, including your school counselor, the nurse, and student assistance counselor, and possibly one of our resource officers. So you get to get a sense and get to meet people who are going to help support you along the way. As you tour the 1112 campus, you're going to end up in our field house where you're going to obtain a Chromebook, and you're also going to get your picture taken for your ID and yearbook. So plan your attire accordingly for the orientation, knowing that you're going to get a picture for the yearbook as well at the end. And then all students are going to be picked up in Lot A, which is our lot behind the field house, between the field house and Polytech, right off of Junction Road, right across from the back of Costco. Realize that we have safety measures in place here for this year's orientation, a little different than previous years. Students are going to be arriving at staggered 20-minute intervals to form groups of 20 to go through so that we can maintain small groups in a safe manner. All students and staffs will have their masks on and will be maintaining proper distancing throughout. The groups will not intermingle, and the groups will also not remain at any one location for more than 20 minutes. If you haven't already, please look for an email from me, E. Brandt, for specific times of when you are to arrive on campus and when they are to be picked up. The next slides give a visual again of where these drop-off and pickup areas are. The drop-off area is right outside the auditorium, which is in our main lot right off of Route 31, Lot G. It's also called our fountain lot. So you drop the student off there and exit at the same location. And then after orientation, when it's complete, and again, look for the email that gives you an approximate time, the pickup is to take place off of Junction Road on the other end of campus between the field house and the Costco lot. I mentioned that the last step of the orientation is for you to be picking up your Chromebooks. All students in Hunterdon Central get a Chromebook for their 4 years. This is yours to keep for the 4 years and take care of. It will be returned at the end of 4 years, though. There was part of the summer information on Aspen is a device voucher that must be completed and submitted through Aspen, along with some of the other paperwork, for example, the emergency contact information and such. Realize that we have optional insurance that is available of $30 per year. Understand that a typical repair for a screen would be $50. So consider the fact that $30 would cover that each year. On campus, we also have other computer setups as well. And realize too that we have a BYOD, or bring your own device program, where if a student, instead of using the school Chromebook, if they wanted to have their own personal computer situated with our IT department so that they can access our guest wireless network. Contact our IT department for that. And just some final comments and things to remember. Look back at the email that you should have received over the summer that dealt with taking care of the Chromebook voucher and insurance on Aspen. Also realize that all incoming freshmen have to have their updated physical information to our health offices by September 30th. Also, proof of residency for all freshmen need to be returned to the freshman house offices. There are outside the vestibule of the 910 receptionist, there is a collection box, a little mailbox for these materials to be dropped off in case you drop them off at off hours. I highly recommend all students pay attention and text to themselves their bus numbers. You're going to get a bus number sent to you from our transportation office. Traditionally, a lot of students forget what their bus number is on that first day of dismissal, and then they're not sure what bus to go to. So highly recommend, little tip there from over the years, to text that bus number to yourself so that you have it. Those are some of the things to remember as you enter the school year. And this last slide, just a little reminder that there will be an online shirt sale coming soon. Students, once you get your Chromebooks up and running and you get your credentials to access your Gmail account, I highly recommend that you periodically, on a regular basis, check your email account, because a lot of information is going to be coming forward, both from the house offices, from your counseling, and also the district-wide email. Again, welcome to Hunterdon Central. Hope you enjoyed this evening's presentation. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to Mr. Schneebly, Ms. Cooley, or myself, or any of your counselors as well. And then look forward to a great start to a wonderful school year. Thank you.